Hello, Brad Ditchie here to give you a quick video of how I got my tickets and a brief little walk around of the new museum in Washington, D.C., which is the National Museum of African American History and Culture. You have to wake up at 6:30 and get the daily tickets because right now you can't book the tickets until after January, and there was no Christmas break or the holiday break, and I wanted to go ahead and shoot on up there. They're not taking reserve tickets until I think January, so you can go in April. So you can't really reserve no tickets in advance unless you're going after April. So if you want to go now, you have to get up at 6:30 or go wait in line outside the museum, and hopefully they will let you in. When I went up there, that line waiting for the walk-ins was very long. So I was happy that I reserved my tickets knowing that I live about 3 hours away. But you gotta wake up at 6:30. I got the tickets I reserved for. I went and checked back 20 minutes later just to see what was available, and all the tickets were sold out. So 6:30 in the morning, you gotta be up and ready. And you can see on my video to show you how I went through it and what I did. It's a nice museum, very big building. You're not gonna really maybe get a chance to read and see everything in one day. It's a lot of people there, very packed, 45 minutes just to get into the downstairs exhibit. And that's probably where most of the museum is at. As they said, 60% of the museum is the underground portion, and the line to get there was, again, 45 minutes. So you want to get there early, get a good experience. If you're from the West Coast, I will probably wait till the summertime, because the crowds are huge, and coming from that far of a distance, you want to get the most out of your trip. And again, you ain't gonna be able to pre-order your tickets to go until after April anyways. I mean, you can order them in January, but the closest date you could be able to get is April. So you might as well wait the summertime, shoot on over, visit the museum, have a good time, visit all the museums, enjoy DC. Again, the Museum of, I gotta keep looking at it because I want to make sure I say the whole name. The National Museum of African American History and Culture. Go check it out. We'll stop blabbering and get on with the video. Thank you.
Six in the morning. Just getting up. Today, we can try to score them tickets. Hopefully today, what is it, Friday, 23rd to something. One, I hope it's open today. Shit, it's not a guarantee. For two, there's nobody even know about this. So, I don't even know if this is gonna work out. Got the coffee going. Coffee time. Matter of fact, I'm plugging in the super fast internet. We ain't using Wi-Fi. We going court.
6:27.
Pushing it close. Alright, I don't see this.
A little closer. Right there.
Alright. I got this saved under right there. No tickets available. It just said 6:30, yo.
Fuck.
6:30 a.m. 6:30 a.m. It said right there, right? 6:30 right now. So, Q, we got it. So, we got it. 6:30. All you do is click on. Woo! Can't believe it. You got to get your butt up. So, what you got to do is go to the website, 6:30. If you get there before 6:30, it's going to say it is not ready yet. Alright? So, as soon as 6:30 hit, you pick a time. You click on the time, and you go being queued in a line like this right here. That's it. I mean, we did it together. Let me see. Pull it off. They're going to put you queued in a line with that screen. You wait for that screen for your queue to finish. And then you get the how many tickets you signed up for. You continue. They'll email it to you. You go inside your email. This is the list right there. View registrations. You click that. You print out your tickets. You're ready to go.
You don't believe me? Really? Like I'm making this up? Perish altogether in the flames. Being in this dreadful captivity and horrible slavery without any hope of deliverance, beholding the most dreadful scenes of misery and cruelty. This made me often tremble and weep.
Yeah, we went the wrong way.
I have known meat to commit acts most shamefully, to the disgrace not of Christians only, but of men. I have no
conditions of slavery do not yet define.
Come on.
In some instances, a few Africans in America had limited degrees of freedom. On large plantations, slavery was a majority. This enabled them to maintain cultural practices and create new American cultures.
Home.
In large port cities like Charleston,
right now we're right here.
Enslaved men, women, and children often worked in a variety of trades as domestics, craftsmen, dock workers, and local vendors. In bustling cities, free and enslaved Africans had more opportunities to meet, build relationships, and share information. On small, rural farms, enslaved people often formed close relationships with American Indians and European indentured servants. They labored, lived, and rebelled together. The law based slavery on African descent and made it hereditary and lifelong. This separated indentured Europeans and enslaved Africans. It created whiteness, and Africans became black in colonial North America. The race-based system of slavery was cemented into law. It was fundamental to the growing colonial economy and would prove it.
Across the nation, free African Americans forge tight-knit communities and neighborhoods. Facing racism, violence, and economic hardship, free people of color are living in cities, small towns, and
publicly inspected and sold to the highest bidder, African American suffered humiliation and heartache. In 1820, 40% of enslaved people sold at auction between the ages of 14 and 25. 28% were under the age of 13. Many were taken for orphans, never to be seen again. Henry Bibb, born a slave in Kentucky, and his sixth and were sold to different buyers. Bibb attempted escape several times before he finally succeeded.
The actions of African Americans helped convince him to issue the Emancipation Proclamation on January 1st, 1864. An order that freed those living in Confederate states. The Civil War became a battle for freedom. The United States military opened up its ranks to African American soldiers who became, in essence, a liberating army.
Fred, I've been a report someone did on you in my lifetime.
They risked their lives even though they faced harsh
can't get that?
Nope. What? Mommy, it's the big plane that we saw outside.
Yeah.
On plantations, in small towns and cities, African Americans acted on their own behalf. They built schools, churches, and businesses. Visible displays of independence and achievement.
Sit up.
Yet hostility toward Black Americans was still pervasive. And the state governments passed laws resembling slavery. African Americans in Virginia spoke out. We have no right to testify before the courts in which a white man is one of the parties to the suit. We are defenseless before our enemies. Give us the suffrage to secure justice for ourselves. Under President Andrew Johnson, there was no federal protection, and African Americans became targets of terrorism. Their symbols of freedom went up in flames. Outraged, Congress took control and divided the South into military districts, requiring those states to write new constitutions and ratify the 13th Amendment, abolishing slavery. At the local level, African Americans continued to push for equal rights. They demanded civil rights and celebrated the passage of the 14th Amendment, which granted African Americans citizenship and equal protection under the law. And they pressed for the right to vote, which was secured in part by the 15th Amendment. With the vote, African Americans ushered in change and held elective office in every Southern state. They instituted the South's first public school systems, fair labor laws, and debt relief. With more than 1,500 African American men in elected office, black voters recognized the impact of the political power they now held. They pressed to expand American freedoms in the House and in the Senate. Representative Robert B. Elliott, speaking to the House of Representatives, said, "It is a matter of regret to me that it is necessary at this day that I should rise in the presence of an American Congress to advocate a bill which simply asserts equal rights and equal public privileges for all classes of American citizens." Uncomfortable with black citizenship, the Supreme Court began to chip away at equal rights. Terrorist organizations like the Ku Klux Klan waged war on African Americans and their political allies. They formed armed combat units to block polling places and fire on black voters. Many were murdered without consequence as they tried to cast their vote. Reconstruction came to an end when Democrats swept the South during the 1876 presidential election using fraud and violence. The Republicans did not fight back. They compromised. In exchange for the presidency, Rutherford B. Hayes agreed to withdraw federal troops from the South. This left African American voters defenseless against murder and fraud. Elections were stolen, and black representation nationwide was stripped. Some African Americans resisted by leaving the South. Others stayed to nurture the communities they had built. African Americans continued to claim the right to belong. Each year, on Emancipation Day, they took to the streets. Together, black labor unions, churches, fraternal orders, and women's clubs organized parades to celebrate emancipation while calling attention to the promises made, but not yet fulfilled.
As you watch from the lunch counter, a member of your group is pulled from the stool and
protest marches, boycotts, and media events were staples of the civil rights movement of the 1960s. Yet, these tactics and others were used by African Americans decades ago.
In 1960s, thousands of African Americans marched
in the two sections, can we set the color? Can we set the color section?
Booker T. Motel. In the 1940s, black communities from New York to Los Angeles waged boycotts under the slogan, "Don't buy, can't work," to protest job discrimination. And in response to a new court ruling, an interracial...
5 million African Americans who began to pour out of the South as World War II approached. This time, they moved north and west, to cities like Alameda and Richmond in California, and Portland, Oregon. When the war arrived, the cities were strange and confusing to the city. African American newspapers and organizations worked to help the newcomers get settled into their lives. They still faced discrimination, but their children were gaining new opportunities. Northern schools weren't without problems, but here they would have the chance to learn. Life's uncertainties would continue, but their eyes were on the future. The Great Migration had transformed the lives of hardworking African Americans, and they in turn had transformed
One of them is just white. This one is just white.
Free within ourselves.
In the first half of the 20th century, 6 million African American men, women, and children left their homes in the rural South.
With the great migration of African Americans from the rural South to cities in the North, there was an awakening among black artists, writers,
and
musicians.
To a new court ruling. An interracial group traveled south in the 1940s. The task of the states would enforce the ban of segregation on interstate buses. Organizers called it the journey of reconciliation. It was bold.
Thank you. Yeah.
Whipped cream. And the truth.
On a deeper level, you are extremely vulnerable when it comes to your children, and totally ruthless when it comes to your enemies. And there are quite a few of those hanging about.
Excuse me.
Now you come on, give it them pants, Miss Jenny. Come on! Now you scrub yourself in that strong line so while I come down and scrub you myself. I'm going to put these pictures in the bottle.
It's a thing that's been happening to me all my life. And just now, it's the first time I ever heard it put into words. I guess that's the way it is when you love.
You're better than me. I've fallen dominated and forced to see. However, I have done. Funny that.
This morning, I'm thinking I'm 35 years old. I'm married, 11 babies, and I got a boy who's at the sleep in the living room because I got nothing else.
I'm going to give him a chance.
Thank you.
and then like one floor, yeah, and then you'll go like.
Wrap around downstairs one floor.
I like that dress.